he's here tonight. The handoff to Nick Brossette. All kinds of running room. Off to the races. And into the end zone. A touchdown for LSU from 50 yards. Talking to his dad, it was time to transfer out, get a chance to play. Here's Brossette. Manny Diaz, the defensive coordinator, said LSU will check your oil up the middle every now and then, and they've done it effectively.
This is just power. Block down, watch the right guard, Brumfield, come up and lead the way through. Just straight north-south running.
Burrow has them up quickly, has a man caught at the pylon. Ja'Marr Chase.
I think they're going to say he was out before he crossed the pylon, just inside the one-yard line.
Yeah, they confirmed there was no signal.
The ruling on the field is a completed catch. First down.
A little stop and go, a little stutter step by Chase is what beat Javonte Dean.
The LSU is racing up to the line, and Brossette scores a touchdown. Looked like it might have been a touchdown on the previous play had it been reviewed. But it doesn't matter now. Brossette, who hadn't scored in his entire career. And Cortez Kennedy. That's really where Ed made a name for himself. His team up 17-3 and out firing. Wide open receiver, Justin Jefferson. Lost the ball, but he was well out of bounds at the end of the play.
It was a multi-sport stadium.
Men's and women's soccer, lacrosse, the field hockey team, they all played out there with 1,200 seats. He's in Jerry World tonight.
Well, the line of scrimmage has been their biggest problem. That was an excellent run on that first down play.
And LSU brings pressure off the corner. It's deflected and intercepted. This is going to be a touchdown for Jacob Phillips.
That's tough, asking those guys to block a defense like this in your running game.
Well, Michael Irvin suffered a preseason knee injury. A high throw. Rozier was hit as he threw it. It's intercepted. Being brought back by John Battle to the 40-yard line.
To kicking into luxury suites. This is his longest attempt. It'll be a 54-yarder.
Low line drive, and it's his night. Raised the crossbar and went through. In the fourth quarter when they absolutely had to, here's another. Fourth down and 10 from the LSU 40 with 4:48 to go. Down by 16, a blitz. Rozier spun around. The only question from here, do they grab him by the face mask?
And a terrific start for Ed Orgeron. Workmanlike performance by his new quarterback. They've solved their kicking problem without any question.
Berglund. Burrow gets rid of it quickly. He's got Chase reaching into the end zone. Touchdown, Tigers.
If they do want to try to get a 5-yard quick out, they have an opportunity.
Burrow. He's going to have to chuck it downfield. He will. End zone, is it caught? Touchdown! 6'6", Stephon Sullivan! On third and goal, the snap over the head of Nunez, picked up by LSU! Jacoby Stevens tripped up almost six.
Now, it has been a conservative game plan in the second half, but we've seen Southeastern move the ball on the LSU defense a few times. Hilaire, Clyde Edwards-Hilaire into the end zone for six more, and that makes it 30-0 Tigers.
Last week, I promise you.
LSU wins it 31-0. We've now seen the Tigers 2 weeks in a row.
Cam Martin now in the Auburn backfield. Stidham throws on a run, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Grant Delpit. Right on cue. Elair to take the direct snap. The number two tailback, right side in. Touchdown, LSU. So the interception turns into a touchdown. Elair behind Burrow. He fakes it to and comes up firing deep. Man up there. Did he keep his foot in? Yes, he did. Let's go. He sends in a new troop, and they will go on fourth and one. They're not going to get there. Not even close. Whitlow swarmed under by Devin White and Michael Divinity.
There's nobody better at hitting the hole and timing out the snap than Devin White.
At the 22, first down. Play fake. Burrow sets his feet, fires deep right sideline. Got his man all alone. Justin Jefferson with another. Second and nine from the 44. They'll set back in there and a first down run. Three more tacked on for LSU. First and goal, Auburn at the six. Long delayed handoff to Whitlow, touchdown. Shivers, left side, walking in, touchdown. Seven-yard attempt to try to make it a one-possession game. Cole Tracy up just inside the right upright. Stidham throws, intercepted. Greedy Williams getting greedy again. Eighth interception of his career. His second of the season. With 87,000 screaming. On a play fake. Deep middle.
Got it. Complete to Derek Dillon. Dillon on the run. Can they get him?
Unbelievable.
What a throw.
71 yards later. A two-point conversion coming up. Third and seven. Trips up to the top for Joe Burrow. Here comes an extra rusher. Burrow throws wide. Oh, what a catch.
Wow.
D. Anderson and a first.
It's got to be part of the decision. They don't know if they can get the ball back again.
They're 1-for-2 on fourth downs on the season. 0-for-1 today. Burrow over the middle. Got his man. First down. Stevon Sullivan.
I tell you, I am tipping my hat to Joe Burrow, okay? Anybody gets, when he needed it before, he brought the house. Will he do it again? Yes, he will.
Second and 10, Burrow. Lofts it again for Jefferson. In and out of his hands. He's looking for a flag, and there it comes.
That's just undisciplined football. You can't allow that to happen.
With 73 made field goals.
So they lost 3 yards on that play, so it'll make it, what, 41, 42-yard field goal, somewhere right in there.
Here's the ball game from 42 yards away. Josh Groden is the holder. Blake Ferguson will snap it. If it's good, they go back to the Bayou, first place in the West.
Can Auburn get a push and get their hands up?
Cole Tracy to win it for LSU. Kick out of the way, and it is dead center. And the 13-game home winning streak for the Tigers has ended. And Cole Tracy's on the bottom of that mayhem. Really good football game. We'll be right back. And what a clutch kick by that guy.
And how about the modern world of college football? He found out at Ohio State he wasn't going to be the starter, and he said, okay, I'm off to do something else.
And that's time for the play of the game, presented by Napa Auto Parts. You got to have a good snap, a good hold, and a great kick. That's all three on the Napa play of the game. And here's how Chris Blair called it for LSU.
Tigers trailing Auburn 21-19. Here's the snap. Placement is down. Kick is up. Line drive. Kick. And it's good! Tigers win! Tigers win! 22-21!
We knew the Tigers were going to win one way or another today. In this case, it happens to be the Tigers of LSU. Huge win on the road. They take that step toward the SEC West where they want to be. Another big one coming up tonight with Ole Miss and Alabama. But coming in ranked 12th in the country, they just picked off the number 7 team in the nation, and I'm assuming they're going to move up in the polls next week.
Time that the Bulldogs have won in this series, you've got to go all the way back to 1904 when they played twice in one season. Smith with a fastball, and that comes loose, scooped up by the Tigers. The defense pounces and delivers in a major way. It's Devin White on top of it. Edwards-Helaire with the toss and an army in front of him down the sideline. He tiptoes his way in for six. Back to throw his 41st pass of the night. And this one's looking deep. At the goal line. And it's a touchdown. He finds Hardy again from 42 yards, and it's a ball game here in Baton Rouge. Edwards-Helaire across the pile, and he's got the touchdown, his second of the night. 21 at one point in favor of LSU. Coach O and the Tigers continue to roll. The number 6 team in the country is now a perfect 4-0. It's been a great couple years for him. Top 10 wins, 3 of them. Coach O's got 3. Nick Saban and Urban Meyer. He's in great company.
Second and 15 to throw. Shot down the sideline, and it is.
Roster hit for generation. They're looking healthy. The generation that can sweep away.
Cut. It's nice, nicely done.
Going to throw. Taking a shot. It is caught. Jamar Chase for the touchdown. Handoff. Nick Brosette.
Missed on his last 5. Third and 10. Do I hear 6? Tabu didn't feel the backside pressure and he's dropped. Who else? It's Grant Delpit again. Adding to his sack totals.
22, the running back. Had a wide open man to his right and it lets to stay on the ground. Did he get there? He did. Touchdown.
Some meaningful snaps.
Second and 6, Burrow to throw. Lost one, man fell down in coverage. It's Justin Jefferson down the sideline for the score. 65 yards, another touchdown for the Tigers. Quick throw to A.J. Brown, trying to get him in some space. He'll cut in. See the signal, waiting for the indication, and there it is. Touchdown.
Ole Miss. And games have tightened up on them in the second half. They're trying to avoid that tonight. On the way is Terrence Marshall. That's one way to hang on to a big lead. Marshall down the sideline. He is pushed out inside the 10-yard line. Keep in mind, LSU has fumbled their last two trips into the red zone. Here they are knocking on the door again. Burrow to throw. And it is caught complete. Touchdown, Justin Jefferson. An answer, and in a hurry, by LSU. Burrow still running with the football. The Tigers' leading rusher will get it for the touchdown and take the extra hit at the end. Touchdown LSU, 35 yards.
Wants to take care of you.
Zeros on the clock. Maybe you'll hear from Coach O on SportsCenter and Scott Van Pelt. Final score, Baton Rouge, all LSU tonight, 45-16. For Brian Griese, Todd McShay.
Easily the team that wins the ground game in this game wins the ball game as well. Justin Jefferson was the motion man, and it's Burrow off play action on first down and going deep for Jefferson. Got him! One play and a big one to Justin Jefferson.
To just box out.
Brosette, easy touchdown LSU on their opening drive. His seventh of the year.
A perfect drive.
Franks on play action, steps up, going deep to the corner. Got his man. Is he in? Touchdown. Josh Hammond.
I think we talked about leaving the field with your quarterback having confidence. How about that confidence on that throw?
49-yard pickup plus the penalty. And now on first down, Franks wants more. To the end zone. Intercepted. And it's Delpit with the pick in the end zone. They give it right back.
Only 19 yards in the third quarter.
Here's Brosette finding him some room and some help. Nick Brosette all the way out to the 50.
Going into that play, the long
quarterback about 9 years ago. Ricky, his other brother, he's 5 years older. Played defensive back. Here comes Brosette. And Nick Brosette on the way. Two biggest runs of the day, and it's first and goal. Let's see if Joe Burrow takes it himself. Nope, keeps it on the ground inside. Touchdown. Nick Brosette, he did all the work, and he got the final yard.
Coming into that drive.
Red zone, touchdown-wise today. Let's see if they can get another one. Here's an end-around pass. Back to Franks to the three. Practice here today. At the two-yard line. P-line, off tackle, touchdown, Florida.
What an answer.
It's intercepted by Florida, Brad Stewart. Touchdown. We said it a few minutes. Burrow, what a catch by Marshall again. Freshman on freshman, he beat
as Minister for Women and Youth, and
we saw him with the game winner at Auburn. This will be a 33-yard field goal attempt, and it's up and good. So the Tigers got a long pass up to a 31-yard field goal. 9 of 11, as you see, on the season. From the left hash to try to tie the game, and it's a fake, and it's Blankenship trying to carry it. Down he goes. Devin White.
Well, Kirby tried to play a less margin to slant and roll your coverage away from him.
Edwards-Helaire, first down, and he busts into the secondary. Edwards Elair in a foot race. Inside the 10-yard line. J.R. Reed saved a touchdown. And I know you're watching, and we'll try to carry on without you. Joe Burrow to throw on deep middle. Jefferson wide open. Justin Jefferson inside the 20, still fighting for yards. These are Cole Tracy field goal attempts. This one will be from about 36 yards once they spot it down. The kick is perfect. So tack on three more. He's in the shotgun this time, though. Well, didn't matter. Edwards Elair into the secondary, and it's inside the 20 for the Tigers again.
Well, you know how impressive.
This deep in LSU territory at the 36-yard line. Pressure coming off the backside. Fromm knows it, and Logan's got him all wrapped up. Well, last time on third down, Fromm had that long throw to Hardman. Let's see what he comes up with on this third down. He's in trouble. Down he goes. Michael Divinity with a sack.
Wow, what a spin this guy can line up with any of them, and all of those guys played in the NFL.
Some still are.
Yes, they are, including the oldest one, Reggie. Father Time Nelson.
Not a good spot for Jake Fromm. Third down and 10. Four-man rush. Throws. Is it intercepted? Very close to him. Christian Fulton got up with the ball, but I think it's
him as a tailback.
Field. Heading to the goal line, end zone, touchdown, Elijah Holyfield. Get a one-possession game here in the waning seconds of the third quarter. They come up to the line in a hurry. Fromm the pitch. Now it's an end around. And it's DeAndre Swift, and he's short. Devin White made the tackle. At the 34-yard line. Hardman in a slot to the right side. That's where Riley Ridley is as well. Corner blitz may be coming. It is. Holyfield picks it up. From looking and waiting too long.
Gotta throw it. Now you're out of field goal range.
That's the Baton Rouge and Tiger Stadium. Don't forget, later in the game, play of the game presented by Napa Auto Parks.
Well, if I'm LSU, I'm challenging my offense. Can you run the ball? They ran for 110 in the first half, only 33 yards in the second half. And remember, the last two passes Joe Burrow threw were nearly intercepted. Georgia has shut down LSU's running attack in the second half.
Edwards Elair is the guy in the backfield right now from the 14. As Burrow will give it off to him, and this is a good run, and Edwards Elair into the secondary. LeCount's got to bring him down, but it's a big gainer.
You get over here if you're LSU.
Jefferson in motion. They fake. Burrow loads it. Going deep middle. Got a man. Jefferson on the catch. In between two defenders.
I think Richard LeCount, number two, the safety, thought he had it. I thought he thought that he had an interception on the play. Tyson Campbell was beat, but the free safety was standing right there. I thought when Joe Burrow threw it, he was crazy, but he got away with it.
Got it to the 18-yard line. Now the toss sweep. Edwards Elair heading toward the goal line. Did he get in? Not quite, but he's close. And the sideline going wild with LSU with a 9.5 minutes to go and a big lead.
Coming out.
Nico Hardman trying to make something happen.
He ran right through that.
And now he lost the ball. LSU, I think, has got it. Might have been the kicker, Atkins.
They got the ball, LSU does. Holy cow.
They finally got the chain set again. Georgia's trying to go hurry up, and I think they need a younger chain gang. They're having a hard time getting down the field at the 27. From to the end zone, touchdown, Riley Ridley. And there's the first score they needed. They can get it down almost to the five-minute mark, and Burrow uses all of his play clock. He does a pretty good job of it. And now he's going to keep it himself. Joe Burrow on the run. A stiff arm. And Burrow trying to ice it himself. He's going to walk in the corner. Touchdown, LSU. Georgia falls to 6-1 and 4-1. LSU climbs to 6-1 and 3-1. So there'll be a shakeup in the top 15 in the country as LSU will move forward in the rankings and Georgia will fall. Big, big home win for
guys who are hungry all week. A lot of respect for Georgia. We know we have to play our best ball. This is our best game by far of the year.
When did you know you took this game over?
You know, I just felt that the whole game, when we came out in the first half to play the way we did, we could physically stand with them. We stopped their running in the second quarter. I felt good about it.
Joe Burrow, the toughness, the way, I know what people want to tell him how to slide and how to get out of bounds, but his toughness today really carried you guys?
No question. Joe's tough. He's a leader. Give credit to the offensive line. This is a great defense. To put the amount of points we had, just a tremendous team win.
Coach, thank you. Congrats.
Go Tigers.
You knew she was going to wait for that last two words. Go Tigers, and it'll probably cost him a little bit by the crowd on the field, but it's time.
Five by the Tigers. They stopped the run. The leading rushing team in the SEC, the Georgia Bulldogs, holding them to 113. Georgia came in averaging 245. Georgia was untested. They got tested, and they didn't pass the test here in the Death Valley.
Well, it's, you can call it Death Valley. I call it Burrow Rouge. A new hero has been anointed. That guy carries the personality of team. And you and I said it coming into the game. There was going to be some measure of desperation.
Yes.
And it showed. You mentioned the 275 yards on the ground.
LSU brings pressure up the middle. Fitzgerald's pass is intercepted. At the 40-yard line, it's Michael Divinity taking it back. Inside the 10. Divinity inside the 5. And out of bounds at the 2-yard line. It'll be first and goal, Tigers.
Are in the backfield now on third and goal. Brossette is in. Touchdown, LSU.
Get a little bit. Give him a run pass option on the perimeter if the pass isn't there.
Fourth down and 3. Or maybe they're trying to get, no, thought they might be trying from outside. Fitzgerald in trouble. He gets out of it. Now being chased inside. Delpit gets him down. Boy, it didn't look like. From the 45, Burrow off play action. Going downtown. Caught inside the 30 by Edwards Elair. This one hugs the left upright and is good. The left. It may happen, though. Fitzgerald on 2nd and 5. Steps up. Throws deep. And a great play by Battle. Intercepting Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, another interception. It's Delpit with a 2nd. Joe Burrow threw an interception in the red zone in a tight game early on, but was really good after that. Deserves a lot of credit for where the Tigers are at this point of the season.
LSU even gets a stop here, this place is going to come unglued. Third down and 18.
LSU has to play safe here. Zone. Let it happen in front of you.
They're going to bring a corner blitz from Delpit. And down goes Tagovailoa. There's flags down. Unless LSU was offside, I don't know. Michael Divinity is the guy that got there.
For LSU, without Devin White, I've been calling this crowd all week the 11th man. Yeah. They're the extra guy that LSU defense wants to help them get through this half before number 40 can come out and make it a ball game, if it's a ball game in the second half.
A little option pitch to Damian Harris. Broke one tackle, but not the rest. Rashad Lawrence and company are there. And it looks like the string of scores in every game is going to dissipate right here for LSU. Got a first down right now from the 40. Damian Harris behind him. Fakes it to Harris. Pressure coming. Going to throw it deep. Man out there and it's intercepted. Picked off by Todd Harris. Big play and the first interception of the year thrown by number 13. Well, see if Devin White comes flying in. He's trying. Tagovailoa flushed out of the pocket. He'll run with it. He's got the first down and more. Still on the run. He is gone. Touchdown, Alabama. 44 yards. And he's holding his knee. She can, but it was another touchdown and a 22-0 lead for Alabama. On the return, he's got something working on a kickoff return. Still on his feet. Edwards Helaire trying to give LSU a spark on the special teams. Second and 9. Jefferson settles into the slot on the left, and Burrow down the middle and got him on the run. Justin Jefferson to the 45. Back to Tuscaloosa. We'll meet Mississippi State next week here on CBS. Bergeron's got the right thing going on here, though. They just need some more players, some more playmakers, and definitely not enough offense tonight. That was going to be their
next protection. He's going to lob one deep. He's got a man open. Justin Jefferson.
No knowledge of judicial philosophy. You simply not qualified and understand.
Strike from Burrow to Jefferson. Going up when it's a quarterback that's going to the ground. 14th play of the draft for LSU. Here's Brissett straight up the gut. Got some help and takes it inside the 5. Turns his way to the goal line. And he is in on a physical 12-yard run. Play action. Wide open is Justin Jefferson. He bends it to the outside. And with a stiff arm, he finds another 15 yards. How about yards? We can know it's a different opponent, but Clyde Edwards-Helaire pauses, breaks free, and punches it in. 13-yard touchdown run. No field goals than anyone else in college football in his career. And he's able to split the uprights again. Timeout. Here comes pressure. Story lets it go. End zone. Jump ball. Caught! Touchdown! Razorbacks, a little trash talk.
Helps you recover much more quickly.
Story drops back to his own goal line. Chucks one down the middle, and it's picked off! Intercepted by LSU. Another pick for DBU. Not only are their DBs good, but their linebackers can cover as well. Pressure coming. Story heaves it. Caught. O'Grady inside the 10. Backs his way down and gets over the goal line for an Arkansas score. Kick a field goal if you have to, and get out of here. Brissett, forget about the field goal. He's staying down to run the clock instead of taking the 7, which would have ended the game. So if you had Brissett on your fantasy team, just like Todd Brown, you'd be upset. He'll get it for you here. Oh, he goes down just shy of the line.
He does not want to score.
This point of credit to Chad Morris and his Arkansas team. They've had a tough schedule this season. They've had a tough year, but they've never stopped, and tonight was a great example.
Off play action. Pocket holds up. Deep throw into single coverage. Touchdown, LSU. Stephon Sullivan goes up to get it on a 38-yard. Texas A&M in the season finale. Blitz up the middle. The throw over the middle. Tomorrow, the tight end for the touchdown. The Owls dial up the pressure. They don't get to Burrow. He throws to the end zone. Diving grab. Touchdown, LSU, as Justin Jefferson. Up play action with all sorts of time. Single coverage has been there tonight. A stretch at the goal line. It's a little bit too late for Chase, who steps out of bounds at the 2.5.
And leg drive, Leonard doing the same.
He does it again. Coming from Stanford, going to Houston, trying to build things up.
Burrow keeps wide open space. Touchdown. His fifth rushing touchdown of the season. Mon Sternberger, touchdown.
To buy time, but in the red zone, easier for a defense to collapse.
One-on-one, end zone, caught, Jefferson.
We had to wait for Davis to come open late.
Catch made, and it's dropped. Dropped by Giles, and it's picked up by Buddy Johnson. Georgia playing its best football of the season. Meanwhile, Kellen Mond now two straight completions. But this one is a loss and a fumble. It's stripped away. Streaking the other way is Michael Divinity. Touchdown, LSU.
Three guesses going as well to tie this game up.
Well, Mond only has two second half completions. Burrow 7 for 8. And Leonard Fournette turns on the Jets, breaks tackles, is an inside the 35.
Gas.
Fake to Brossette. Moreau. Touchdown. Bulldozing his way to give the LSU Tigers the lead.
I didn't think Moreau.
Words to go for Texas A&M, down 7. Mon trouble with the snap, almost went down to a knee, and that ball is picked off. It's Delpit that'll put it away with his 6th interception of the season. LSU is going to 10 wins.
Pick up. They may be.
Review, the quarterback's knee was down at the 39-yard line. Ball will be placed there where it'll be 3rd down. Please set the game clock to 3.
You'll see.
Last chance on a 4th down for the Aggies. Mond steps up. Catch made at the 41-yard line by Davis. That's a 1st down.
Yeah, hurry up, get over this football. Snap and spike. Spike on the game clock.
After review, when the quarterback spiked the ball, there was 1 second on the clock. Please set the game clock to 1 second. The 2nd down.
We were talking about before, 12 red zone targets coming into this game.
Game on the line. Mond, end zone. Caught! Courtney Davis! Proclaim victory. Mond to Sternberger inside the 5, but he fumbled. He fumbled the football. Now they call it incomplete. Now it's Mond with Williams blocking in front. Touchdown. Brossette stretches to the goal line. Touchdown. Been a while since Edwards Elair has been in the game. Here he is. Looks like he's gonna throw. Carter, touchdown. Why not? Mond, end zone, touchdown, Rodgers again.
And Alaka, the leading tackler for A&M, comes up with a big negative yardage tackle. Missed a couple of practices due to the concussion protocol. Showing up big on that overtime snap.
Burrow. Jefferson makes the grab inside the five first. And Burrow keeps it himself. Touchdown LSU. Now it's the two-point conversion. Burrow got it. D. Anderson says he's not ready to go home. Burrow running all night into the end zone. Touchdown. This one deflected. And even though it's caught, it's short of the goal line as DeAndre.
Bottom of your screen.
Mon, strike to Davis. Touchdown.
Looks like. And they do.
Mon, Rodgers fighting for the ball. Pass interference on Greedy Williams. From outside the five. Mon looking that way. Got it! It's Rodgers! The Aggies win the game of the year in the Southeastern Conference.
Last night, what had to be the wildest college football game of the season, with LSU leading, Texas A&M was able to tie it up in the last second, so it went into overtime, not just once, but a total of seven overtimes, tying a division record. Texas A&M finally won it 74-72, making it the highest scoring game in division history. Still ahead tonight, fans.
On the toss, they want the football first. There will be no deferring here today. Clyde Edwards-Helaire is back deep for the Tigers. And we are underway in the PlayStation Fiesta Bowl. And it is Helaire out to the 20, out to the 25, past the 30, right up the middle. Clyde Edwards-Helaire cutting all the way across the field. And he is taken down by Rashad Causey. Inside the 20, it's a 70. Snap and place are perfect. So too is the kick. Pressure coming, and it's picked off. It's Brandon Moore. Joe Burrow threw it right to him. And Brandon Moore down the sideline. Nobody to beat, and there are no flags. 93 yards. UCF 22. Burrow to throw. Now they'll take a shot. Lofts one for Jefferson. He's got it. Touchdown. What a throw. What a catch. 22 for the score. Third. Greg McCray. And Matt will keep it. And the ball comes out. Turnover. LSU able to recover. It's midfield. There's some pressure from UCF. It's picked up nicely. Throw across the middle. Floated in there for Dillon. Down the sideline. Derek Dillon for the score. A play that looked like nothing turns into something. That was the worst loss for LSU. They were shut out by Bama 29-0 this season. The throw into the end zone. Touchdown, Justin Jefferson. What a throw by Joe
Field to protect that.
So you're not fooling the defense then at that point in the game. Here's Matt to throw. Steps up and fires back in the end zone. Davis is there for the touchdown. Gabriel Davis on the receiver.
receiving end of a strike from Darryl Mack. Well, Set still needs another 23 yards for 1,000. Here's Burrow to throw. Loads up and fires. Got a wide open man. Caught for the touchdown. Jamar Chase. 32 yards for the score. These things, as always, are subject to change. Here's Burrow on 3rd and 9 to throw. Underneath to Dillon. Able to break free. Stays on his feet. Derek Dillon already has a touchdown. Still on his feet. And picking up blocks along the way. In the third quarter. LSU by 10 looking to add to that lead. Here's Edwards-Helaire. Inside the 30. Stays on his feet. And keeps on going. Pushing the pile. Burrow steps up, take another deep shot. Got a man. It's Sullivan.
Seriously looking at it.
Take him right now.
Yes.
Even if they don't come back and win, they've shown you enough. Here's the onside kick. On the way, takes a bounce. It's loose. And I think it's recovered by LSU. Good protection this time. He's got the time. Throws down the middle of the field, bounces up in the air, and it is intercepted. Picked off by Jacoby Stevens, who will just go down with 20 seconds. The conversation, however, will continue, you can be sure of that. Final score of the PlayStation Fiesta Bowl, LSU by 8.